Peace, what's good, everybody? It's the Copper Child, Mike L, and welcome to another episode of the Conscious Black Crystal Connection. We are the Crystal Children, and today's another book club episode. Welcome to the book club. The book of the day is The Book of Stones by Robert Simmons and Nasha Shine. So let's hear what Robert has to say. Well, actually, let's get into the keywords, the elements, and the chakras that correspond with copper. So copper, keywords: channeling and grounding high vibrations, conducting and enhancing stone energies. The element is earth. Chakras are all. Okay, so here's what Robert has to say. Copper is the metal of channeling energies. It has the ability to ground and transfer a wide array of vibrational frequencies from the spiritual to the physical. It is the metal of the magician. It crackles with electricity and fire. But the fire is not its own. It belongs to the higher realms. Copper is a conduit between heaven and earth, and it performs the essential task of providing the medium for manifestation of the invisible to the visible. Copper can carry stone energies the way a copper wire carries electricity. Crystal grids can be enhanced by connecting the stones with copper wire. A quartz laser wand or other crystals can be intensified by wrapping a coil of copper wire around it. One of the most basic energy devices one can make is a copper wire filled with stones and a crystal point at one or both ends. This is the simplest type of energy wand tool. Pyramids or geometric forms constructed from copper tubing filled with crystals make extremely high energy meditation chambers. Copper encourages experimentation and invention. It resonates with the planet Uranus and its energy of revolutionary ideas and unexpected serendipitous change. Copper bracelets, which have long been used for treating arthritis, work by opening the blocked energy flow of which the arthritic symptoms are a manifestation. Okay, so now let's go on to see what Nasha Shine has to say. Nasha Shine goes on to say, copper is a versatile and useful metal for both metaphysical and physical healing purposes. It resonates with the earth element and teaches the ancient ways of walking in balance with the planet and all the beings upon it. Copper is a strong conductor of energy, and it enhances the energy of any earthly stone with which it is used. The exceptions are meteorites and tektites, which can create discordant, overly intense energetic fields when combined with copper. The patina that copper naturally develops as it oxidizes does not detract from its energy. In fact, copper with the patina can be especially helpful for strengthening blood oxygenation capability and respiratory system function. Copper can strengthen the blood and help activate cellular knowledge of one's ancient heritage. It is receptive in its energy rather than directive. It is strengthening to the female reproductive system. Copper is the most powerful metal to use in healing of the physical body, as it aids one in balancing and strengthening all its levels and systems. Copper teaches the way of balance and respect for the earth and its beings. It helps one find inspiration in the natural world and encourages learning through receptive observation. Copper carries the energy of the wise grandmother who has learned much from life, but will only share her knowledge with you when you're patient, respectful, and attentive. Copper carries the energies of thoughts and emotions quite easily. It can help one become more aware of the unconscious inner dialogue that often creates our emotional experience. Copper can aid in gaining wisdom and a higher perspective on emotional experience. Okay, so now we're on to the physical. Copper supports iron and the formation of red blood cells and hemoglobin and the rhombic prismatic liquid crystals that are the life-carrying part of every red blood cell. Copper is an important element in the formation of tissues. It can assist the body in repairing tissues after accident, injury, or surgery. It is an excellent all-round metal to employ in physical healing and recovery work. It can be helpful in strengthening the female reproductive system and can be used in combination with zinc-bearing minerals in the treatment of female infertility, cysts, and other reproductive imbalances. In males, copper can increase general vitality and physical healing. It supports bodybuilding and physical training in general. Affirmation: I call upon the forces of the higher worlds to manifest on earth through me. Okay, now that's one book. That's The Book of Stones by Robert Simmons and Nasha Shine. So That's their perspective on copper on a metaphysical level, spiritual level, mental level, and a physical level. And so that's cool. Appreciate that info. And so we're on to the next book. Okay, and the next book is The Essential Guide to Crystals, Minerals, and Stones. And this is by Margaret Ann Limbaugh. And here's what she has to say about copper. First, she has a chart, and I'll read the chart to you, and I'll also display so you can look at it. So as for colors, she has colors, chakras, planets, numbers, elements, mole scale, and astrological sign. So let me run that down for you. As for color, in relation to copper, metallic, gold, orange. Okay? Chakras, the navel, solar plexus, heart, and the third eye. Planets, the corresponding planet with copper would be Venus. Interesting, because in the other book they said it was Uranus, in this book they say it's Venus. And also in ancient Kemet, they assigned Venus as a corresponding planet for copper. Interesting. And the symbol for copper is actually the Ankh. So, numbers, 29. Element, air. Mole scale, 3. So that would be the hardness of the crystal. Astrological sign, Gemini and Scorpio. So here we go on to an affirmation. Affirmation: I'm a conduit for goodness, prosperity, and love. I am open to receive inspiration, wealth, and good health. My power is immeasurable. I easily transform anger and frustration through conscious release of awareness. My body naturally removes toxic substances from my system. Spiritual uses. Copper has been used by humans for a variety of purposes for nearly 10,000 years. Though orange gold, it also carries the vibration of blue and green. The historic nature of this metal, combined with its colorful variations when exposed to the elements and its thermal and electroconductive qualities, increase your ability to tap into the cosmos to garner wisdom, knowledge, and surprising information that can be applied to your spiritual practice of meditation, prayer, and contemplation. Mental uses. Copper provides a clear conduit for messages and inspiration. This metal is beneficial when working on an invention, formula, or any project that requires a download of insight to complete the task at hand. It is beneficial for writers, musicians, and inventors who feel stumped or stuck. Because of its historical use as money, use it to encourage prosperous thinking and allow it to activate your ability to attract wealth and abundance. Well, so there you have it. Some information about copper. As you can see, a very unique crystal. And I think I'm about to wrap it up for this episode. And thanks for tuning in. The Copper Child Mike L. Signing out. Check out the online store. You can donate through the Cash App if you like. PayPal. It's all good. Thanks for your support.